In this video, we'll discuss some problems of your exercise 6.2. Here in this question, this figure is given to you. They have also given BE parallel OQ, BF parallel OR, and we have to prove that EF parallel QR. Now what we can do, first of all, what is given that we have to use. This part is given, it is of which triangle that will determine first BE parallel OQ. It means I will take triangle PQO. So, in triangle PQO, here it is given that BE parallel OQ. This thing is given to us. If it is given, then based on your basic proportionality theorem, I can write it here PE upon EQ, which is equals to PD upon DE. So, PE upon EQ, which is equals to PD upon DE. Let this one be your equation number 1. Now, second thing, they have given DF parallel OR. DF parallel OR is a part of triangle PRO. So, here I am taking in triangle PRO, they have given BF parallel OR. So, based on your proportionality theorem, you can write here PF upon FR, which is equals to PD upon DO. PD upon DO. Let this one be your equation number 2. Now observe equation number 1 and equation number 2. Here, PE upon EQ equals to, you got PD, sorry, this one is PD. PD upon DO. So, from equation 1 and 2, this PD upon DO will eliminate and I can write it here, PE upon EQ, which is equal to PF upon FR. So, from equation 1 and 2, I can write here, PE upon EQ, which is equals to PF upon FR. Now, observe, PE upon EQ, which is equals to PF upon FR. So, converse of basic proportionality theorem says, if sides are in a ratio, then you can say that two sides which are intersecting at a particular distinct point, then EF parallel to QR. If we are getting two sides are in a ratio, so third side will be parallel to that intersecting side. So, here I can write based on your theorem, EF parallel QR. Hence, prove like that, you can prove it. Next question I am explaining here is, now next question is, prove that line joining the midpoint of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to third side. Let me draw first of all one triangle and I am giving name ABC. Here, line joining midpoint of two sides. So, let this one and this one be midpoint and let it be intersecting at a point E and F. And I have to prove that EF parallel BC. So, first of all, what is given to us that I am writing? They have given that EF intersecting AB and AC at midpoint E and F respectively. Right? And here, what we have to prove? Here we have to prove EF parallel BC. Now, here, are saying that EF intersecting at the midpoint. Midpoint means this E will divide your side into two equal parts. So, I can write it here. AE is equals to EB. And F is dividing your AC into again two equal parts, because F is a midpoint, it is given in a question. So, here I can write here AF, which is equals to FC. Now, observe, If I am shifting a denominator, so as per the multiplicative identity, here 1 will left, EB which is equals to 1. Here also AF upon FC which is equals to 1. Now observe, both of its ratios are same. This ratio value is 1, this ratio's value is again 1. So I can equate as, I can write it as AE upon EB which is equals to AF upon FC. Now observe, here what I have, AE upon EB which is equals to AF upon FC. So based on your theorem you can say EF parallel BC. So therefore EF parallel BC by theorem. Hence proved. One more question I will explain here. Next question, ABCD is a trapezium. So let me draw first of all one trapezium ABCD. ABCD is a trapezium in which AB parallel CD and its diagonal intersect each other at a point O. Diagonals intersect each other at a point O. Show that AO upon OB is equals to, show that AO upon BO is equals to CO upon DO. This thing we have to prove. Now observe this question. They have given one trapezium and here we have to prove AA upon AO upon BO which is equals to BO upon DO. CO upon DO. This part we have to prove. Now things are in a ratio. To get a ratio, I have to apply a theorem. I can apply a theorem only when if I am having one parallel side. So what I am doing? Here I am doing one construction. One construction I am doing here. Here I will join this OP such that OP parallel AB. So join OP such that OP parallel AB and OP parallel CD also. Now let me take one triangle ABD. So in triangle ABD, OP parallel AB, that is our construction. So OP parallel AB. If it is in a parallel, so based on your proportionality theorem, you can write it as DP upon PA, which is equals to OD upon OB. Let this one be your equation number one. Second thing, let me take triangle ADC. So in triangle ADC, here also OP parallel CD. OP parallel CD. If it is parallel, so based on your proportionality theorem, I can write here AP upon DP which is equals to AO upon OC. Now observe, this one is DP upon PA. This one is AP upon DP. To get that same ratio, what I'll do? Here in a denominator, I will take reciprocals. I will get DP upon AP which is equals to OC upon AO. This one is our equation number 2. Now from equation 1 and 2 you can equate. So you will get from equation 1 and 2 I can write it as OD upon OB which is equals to OC upon OA. Now what you want? We want here AO upon OB. So may I switch their places? I will shift this OA here and this OD in a denominator. So I will write OA upon OB which is equals to OC upon OD or DO. This one is C. Hence, O. So like that you can prove your questions using basic proportionality theorem. According to me, if this many questions are understood to you, I don't think that you will face any difficulty to solve such similar questions. Hope you will practice at your home.